So all I got to do is obey the spirit of the Lord. The spirit of the Lord is upon me. And I have been anointed to preach the gospel. To die in wins and die in winners. That's on their way to hell. With no God on their side. He said, tell them that the time has come. For the kingdom of God have come to you.
Man.
Today, my subject should be coming from, if you have Bibles, all of us are supposed to have a Bible. We're on your way to heaven, so you need a roadmap. Turn your Bibles to Matthew 4th chapter. And beginning at the 4th verse. I come to you to bring the gospel, living gospel of Jesus Christ. No altered, but as it is written. Matthew 4th chapter, beginning at the 4th verse. When everyone got it, just say yes.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. And I want you to repeat this as we bring it about. It is written. That man shall not live. Eat. Well, let's get it right now. It is written that man shall not live.
Man shall not live.
By bread alone.
By bread alone.
But by every word.
By every word.
That proceeds out of the mouth of God.
That proceeds out of the mouth of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God.
Thank God.
My introduction today.
Come on, preacher.
Shall be victory. Victory over temptation. You know, temptation is what Satan used on the Christian man and the non-Christian. Temptation is when you are drawn into something and lust and desire. It is a terrible thing when you have no way to control temptation. Temptation is common to all human creatures. And there is no sin in temptation. Why? It is because if you can turn away from temptation, it cannot conquer you. But us as Christian people, we have a faithful God that will assist us when things get too strong for you. He has made an escape for you.
Yes, sir.
That you can turn away and walk away from temptation. But church, I want you to know today that Satan has the greatest tool to bring you down with, and it is temptation. Now, God has sent you the answer to how to avoid that temptation. One part of the Bible says, if you pray and resist the devil, he'll flee from you.
Yes,
amen?
Yes,
you can be victory or have victory or be victorious because God has a way out for you.
Amen.
If the indwelling power of the Lord dwells within you, when you come before temptation, God will not let you be tempted above your ability or the strength of you. He will show you a way out.
Yeah.
Now, if you are tempted and you fall for it, it's not because of God, but it is because of the deficiency of faith and commitment. Right. Amen. Do you follow me?
Amen.
It's not because of the provisions of God, but it's because lack of faith and commitment. There is a way out. That takes me back to the Bible in the beginning. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And the earth was without form of void. And darkness was upon the face of the deep. And now, the Spirit of God moved upon the waters. And God spoke and said, let there be light. And there was light. Tell me that God set the sun out there and set the moon out there. The sun governs the day. And the moon governs the night. Well, after he had made heaven and earth, he'd taken a man. He put that man in that garden. And then after which he said, let us make man a helpmate. And after he made man a helpmate and put him in the garden, he gave him the law. See, out of all this garden, ye may eat of the fruit of the tree. But the one that lies within the midst, don't touch it. Don't look at it. And don't put your hands on it. For the day that you touch it will be the day that you surely die. We is not talking about a physical death, but we are talking about a spiritual death. So it came a day that Eve was there in the garden. And she was walking around and she came unto the tree that God had said is forbidden. The serpent were in them days one of the cleverest of all God's creation. Satan was there in the tree. Eve came to the tree and Satan already knows what he got planned. But you have to watch temptation. So woman came over and looked at the tree. Well, you know, sometimes looking men can mess you up because everything that looks good ain't good. Amen? But Satan said, yea, God has said, the day that you touch this fruit is the day that you're going to die. Talking about temptation. Satan is always on his job. So Satan said, hey, God had told you that you would surely die, but I tell you, if you touch or eat of this tree, you shall become wise as gods. So the woman forgot about the precaution of what God had commanded her. She looked at the tree. Man, if it ain't look good, ain't good. But then when she looked at the fruit, it was beautiful. Sometimes y'all go and shop and get a pretty dress and bring it back home that looked so pretty when it was hanging on the rack there. But when you bring it home, you find out that I don't want it. It don't fit me right. Temptation got you. But Eve believe after she had looked for a long time. She said, I believe I tried. Now listen, now God done gave you commandment, but temptation just got you. She reached up. She said, it looks good. It looks beautiful. It looks fitting for eating. And it looked like it would be a tree that could make one wise. And she taken the fruit from the tree and began to eat. And the Bible said that woman was deceived. But then the last part of her had to come. Adam came and she said, Adam, and Adam eat. Sometimes women, you know, that a man, you choose one thing. The woman said to you, husband, I want a new truck. The husband might say, well, baby, we is not able to buy a new truck. But darling, please get me something new. Because you see, man is always following woman. But did not you hear God and he command you not to do or disobey? Adam also taken off the fruit. And my Bible shows me where in the cool of the evening. Tell me that God came into the garden. And their eyes were wide open. My Bible tell me that they taken fig leaves and made aprons of the fig leaves. And their eyes were open, they hid their necks. But when God came in, he came in, he called, oh man, Adam, where are you? But Adam said, I'm hiding because I am naked. And then God said, who told you was naked? Have you broke my law and went astray? Yes, the blame game come. And Adam said, the woman that thou gavest me, oh Lord, she gave unto me and I did eat. The blame game. Tell me the woman said, the serpent beguiled me. And I did eat too. But ever since that day, men, you've been feeding right there. And God made you work hard. You had to go out into the fields and work hard all day. He said you shall live by the sweat of your brow. And woman, since you were deceived by Satan, you're gonna bear pain when you make children. Tell me, God cast them out of that garden. And they lived in sin from what they did. But I know somebody that can withstand temptation. Tell me, Jesus came down one day. He come left Galilee and came down to the sea of Jordan River. Tell me that John was baptizing in the Jordan River. Help me now, Lord, and I'll soon be through. And he came down. He said, John, I have need of you to baptize me. For the fulfillment of the scripture. But John wanted him to baptize him. But Jesus said, suffer me for the fulfillment of the scripture. And after Jesus was baptized, tell me he came up out of the water. There appeared an opening of the heavens. A dove came down, which was the Spirit of God. And he said, this is my beloved son, in whom I will please. Tell me that the Spirit drove him into the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. So temptation is is the awful thing. When Jesus got there, he had no food for 40 days and 40 nights. And my Bible said, oh Lord, the tempter came and said, look here now, you haven't eaten for 40 days and 40 nights. Tell me, listen to how he said, if thou be the Son of God, will you turn these stones into bread? But I heard Jesus say, man shall not live by bread alone. But every word speaks out of the mouth of the Lord. But that wasn't through with it yet. Got three strikes in the game, so Satan tried again. He took Jesus in a moment of time. He moved Jesus on his own and took him to the holy city of Jerusalem. And he took him and set him on the pinnacle of the church. And tell me, he said, cast thyself down, for God will give charge of the angels to catch you before your feet bear against the stone. But Jesus said that you, that is written, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God, and him only shall you worship. But he went through with Jesus yet. My Bible said he take him, Jesus, up into a mountain high above the earth. Let me take my time now. Oh Lord. And he said to him, look at all the earth and all the earth glory. But if you bow down and worship me, all will this I give you. But Jesus came back and said to him, oh Lord, all belongs to God. Oh Lord, all belongs to God. And thou shalt worship the Lord thy God only. Yes. So Jesus had victory over temptation. You can have victory over temptation. Do you see how Jesus used the word, man shall not live by bread alone, but every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God? Then he went on to tell him when he got ready to tempt him, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Sometimes you say, I prayed to God to send me a husband. I prayed to God to give me a house. But God works in his own time. Those that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. So temptation is a bad thing. We sang the song, victory is mine. Victory is mine. Oh, joy is mine. Peace is mine. Sometimes